keep them on time, right?
Good morning, everyone. Today we're going to be learning about the career journey of Mr. Torres. Mr. Torres works as a dance choreographer, artist, DJ, and CEO for the company Latino Hip Hop Productions. Mr. Torres has been employed in the career world for 20 years, and his favorite part of the job is everything, especially helping people find their passion. Let's give a warm welcome and all of our attention to today's presenter.
Guys, it's nice to be here. My name is Jay Torres. How many of you are happy to be here today? Good. How many of you are happy to be alive? Hey, there we go. Let's be real now, right? Let me share something with you. The first thing you should always do as a human being, I'm going to tell you, because you're young, you're blessed, you have a beautiful mind, and heart and soul and ambition, and you have everything you need to pursue your career, even right now at your age. How old are you? Just say numbers. How old are you?
11.
Ooh! Okay, say it again.
12.
11.
One more time.
12.
12 is that? That's what I heard. Do it again. You guys are young. Like really young. That's a good thing, you guys. That's a good thing that you're young. But I'm going to share something with you. Just because you're young, it does not mean, once again, that you can't start pursuing your career. How many of you guys like to create? Let's start there. How many of you guys like to create? Okay, yeah, okay, you're being honest. Okay, cool. How many of you like music? How many of you like to dance? Yeah, there you go, good. How many of you like to dance but are too shy? Be honest, because I don't have any filter, I'm straight up. Okay. How many of you have a dream, but you feel like it's almost impossible to get there? Be honest and put your hands up if that's you. Okay. How many of you feel that you're able to get to your dream that you have in your head right now? Put your hands up. Good. Okay, good. Be honest. And I appreciate your honesty. Whatever it is that you want to pursue, I'm going to have some good news for you. You can do it. You have everything that you need to pursue your dreams right now. I own a dance company. I am an artist first, dance choreographer, and the CEO of Latino Hip Hop Productions. I'm a founder, actually. I created it. It wasn't around. I made it. I created it. I brought something into this world that didn't have something for me, so I decided to create my own. You want to call me a trailblazer? Do it, because that's what I am. I'm a trailblazer. I created something and brought people together that were not able to even communicate with each other. And now, I have a career. It started out with dancing when I was a little kid. That's why I'm telling you, your career can start now, where you're at. When I was a little kid, I went through a lot of stuff when I was a little kid. I went through a lot of pain. And the only way I could escape my pain is when I started to dance. I felt better. Music, because I stopped talking. So when I heard music, it was like, man, I'm around friends and they're like, I'm like, can you hear that music? And they're like, yeah, I can hear that. I'm like, no. Can you hear the music? Can you hear the instruments? Can you hear all the instruments? Like, really good? Like, bro, like, I can hear it, but, like, not like that. It touched me. It set me free. And then I said when I was little, one day, when I get older, this is me when I was little, like, 5. When I get older, I want to share something with the world to other children that are struggling and share it with them to let them know that you can break out of whatever you're going and you can heal yourself with your own gift and passion. You can heal yourself with what's inside of you. What is inside of you has been instilled in you to share with other human beings because we need it. How do I know this is true? Don't you have an iPhone or a phone? Yes, you do. You may not have an iPhone. You may just have a Samsung. You don't have to have what everybody else has. But somebody came up with the idea. Somebody came up with the idea for this boombox right here. Sony's their name. So they solved a problem. Somebody came up with the idea for this TV, the screen, the building. Somebody thought it out in their head. The chairs and the tables that you're sitting in, don't you need them to sit? Well, hello? Somebody thought of it. Everything on this earth has come from a human being, and we all are connected. We all need something that comes from us. The key is to get it out of you. The key is to develop, write it down, develop. I need to develop my expertise. I need to develop my talent. I need to develop my talent. Where focus goes, energy flows. Listen to me. Where focus goes,
it's not your turn.
What? Where focus goes, energy flows. What you gonna be, 90 years old, be walking like this? Because you're on your cell phone too much? On social media? The one thing that is the problem in this day and age, in your generation, not in mine, but in yours, you got a lot of distractions. You got a lot of distractions. When I grew up, I mean, we had the pagers and all that, you know what I'm saying? I'm hip-hop, we had all that. We had a big old cell phone. Yeah. So we had distractions too, but not as much as what you have. How many of you are careful about your social media, the time that you spend on social media? And be honest, don't lie, be honest. Do you watch your time or you just... Okay, no hands. You're being honest, and I appreciate that. How many of you are on social media a lot? Be honest, put your hands up. Okay. Oh my God. Okay. I'm not gonna be your parent, because I'm sure you hear it from them. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. But I'm gonna tell you straight up. Where focus goes, energy flows. What you feed, you are going to keep alive. The more you read what is on social media and what is coming to you from a person that you don't even know, and they're depositing stuff into you, like I'm depositing stuff into you, that's what you're gonna get. Why do you think you feel a certain type of way when you're talking to someone, or you're in a chat room, or you're on a social media platform, and then you feel some type of way afterwards? Why? because you just opened up your mind and your soul to energy. You let that in. So whatever you let in, you're gonna get out. So don't trip, potato chip. Don't trip. Oh, this is a little discouraged now. Oh my gosh, I might be saying that today. Bro, really, man? That's like, what are you doing? Like, what are you doing? Why are you opening yourself up to that? Are you not better than that? Does somebody have to feed you and tell you to be the person that you need to be? Or can you be courageous and have some boldness and be bold and share who you are and what you really have to say and your input? The other thing is you want to make sure you got boundaries. Straight up, you want to make sure you have boundaries. I don't know where everybody went, but I have something for you. You have to have boundaries, guys. Have boundaries in your life, in your work life, in whatever you want to do. You got to have boundaries. I'm going to tell you why. Why? Okay. Say that your friend is in town, but you're doing something at home. And they're always hitting you up on social media, whatever, all night and day, whatever, right? And then all of a sudden, they go to your house. And you're having a big party and everything like that. What? I was just talking. Didn't we just end the conversation at all? Yeah, but you know, I'm here now, I was in the neighborhood, so I thought I'd stop by. It's me, remember? We're talking last night, like, for hours, come on. Yeah, come in. When you don't have boundaries, don't expect people to respect you. Because they will step into your life and tell you all kinds of stuff that you don't need to hear, especially when you're pursuing your career. If you have a dream, you have to have boldness to carry it out. Because everybody in here has a purpose. Everyone. How many of you have dreams? Big dreams. Good. Put your hand up. Did you know that those dreams will only come alive until you're bold enough and you perform them or even speak them? Let me see your smile. Y'all have a nice smile. Let me see your smile. Good. I like to see young people smile. You know why? Because I don't see that anymore for you. And it's sad. It's sad. It really is. You know, all I'm trying to do, guys, is be right now, appreciate your time and your youth because it goes by fast. Not everybody gets the opportunity to live, you know, a long life, so you gotta take care of yourselves, okay? Okay, what was that? That lady just came in. Okay, so I want somebody to come up here and to read my mantras. Who wants to come back? There you go. Come up here. Courage. You need courage to get places. All of these are good.
Patience, passion, perseverance, first chance, change, focus, faith, forward, discipline, dedication, direction, love, live, left, peaceful, respect, adapt, expect, overcome.
Thank you. That's yours. No, that's my turn. Get it in the room. Thank you very much. Okay. So I want you to take these with you, okay, you guys? Can you pass these out? Thank you. Okay. So I want you to take those with you. Please don't forget. And then you know what? If you need information regards to my dance company, you can scan the QR code right there, okay? With that. Okay. Who has an idea of what you kind of want to do in your career? Put your hand up. Okay, what do you want to do? Very nice. You know what's cool is that the arts, like right now, the Olympics, we have breakdancers now in the Olympics. You know what I'm saying? I was born when hip hop was discovered, basically. Okay? That's why I created Latismo. Mama told me. It didn't exist. Okay? So back to the childhood. My dream came from pain, but my pain pushed me into purpose. My pain pushed me into purpose. There's a blessing in the burden. There's a blessing in the burden. There's always something good that comes out of something bad, but it's your job to react to it properly and to handle it. Don't ever let somebody else's weakness destroy your greatness. You know, there's a lot of people that have weaknesses, especially when we get more mature. And when they're around young folks, sometimes those things come out. And what you need to remember is that don't let anyone ever destroy your greatness from their weakness. Don't let that happen. Because you are great. You are great. And I'm telling you, you have everything you need. Everything. When I was a teenager, I created Waves of Illusion Hip Hop Dance Team at your age. We had assemblies at school. It gave us something to do. We battled each other. We had battling teams. I had a wonderful time battling with everybody. It was cool. It was fun. You know, we would just break up, boom, all kinds of people thought it was a fight and it wasn't a fight. It was just a scrum, you know. That's what we used to do, you know what I'm saying? Like, we just straight up took to the dance floor. And you know, nobody cared either. You know, in your face, boom, what? It was cool. Dancing's a sport. So remember, you guys can do anything you want if you put your mind to it, straight up. Okay, one of the things that I'm going to do is get you guys up. Everybody stand up. Now, we're going to learn a couple of steps, a couple of dance steps. How many of you like Beyonce? How many of you guys like Drake? How many of you guys like Pilo? I'm taking it for different genres here. Okay. You know, learn a little bit of line dancing today. Yeah, a little bit of line dancing in a funky way. All right? Okay, this is what we're going to do. You're going to put your hands on your holster right here. On your holster, yeah. And I want you to do this because even if you're shy, it's going, you know what I mean, bell holster, you know, Texans, you know what I mean. Okay, so right here, right? Okay. And one thing that dancing is the language of the soul. It'll break a lot of barriers, and it breaks a lot of, like, you know, all the anxieties. Start with, I'm also dyslexic, so you're going to see me do this a lot because I have to remind myself that this is dyslexic. Right foot, tap. One, two, three, four. Then you're going to step like this. I don't know if you can see my knee, and I'm going to move back. Like this. One, two, three, four. In. Six, seven, eight. Then you're going to get your right foot, and you're going to put it in the back of the left. One, like this. Cross. Two. And then when that happens, get your left hand and right foot. Hit. Good. Then get your left foot, put it in the back. One, down, and then here, the other side. Okay, back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Back to the center. And then you're going to step like this. Down. One, two, three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Come on, I can do that though. Come on, bro. Yeah. Come on.
This is my third time.
Hey.
Come on.
You guys can do this.
I'm back. Okay. Let's go. Get up. Now. Stand up.
Okay, so then, right? Okay, that, okay. And after that, I know you guys are giggling. That's good.
Okay,
so after that, what we're going to do is go like this. Pretend you got a hat. And then go like this. Off, down, up, and then watch. Go around. No, just your hat. One, two, three, and forward. After that, then you're gonna turn like this. 1, 2, 3.
I'm in the camera.
Try to go sideways. Try to do like a side turn. Like a side turn. Go back. 5, 6, 7, 8, go. 1, 2, 3. That's it. 1, 2, 3. Put your hands right there. Go. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now let's start. Here we go.
Yeah, we got it. I love that. Find your own, you can do it.
And that is to really, really remember who you are. And whatever it is that you want to do, it doesn't matter if you're having financial issues, if you've been going through some type of emotional issue, if you feel alone. Did you know that that doesn't matter? It doesn't. You know what matters? What matters is what you do in the process. You know the storms we had recently, you know, right? They were crazy, right? Weren't they crazy? Okay, all the water and the wind, the storms were outrageous. But if you look outside, those trees are still standing.
Yep.
All of them are. I love eagles and I love lions. Eagles fly alone. They don't need to be around anybody. Their focus is about 4,000 or 400 times more than everybody here, including myself. But I love them because when they focus, they get their prey all the time. They don't eat dead carcasses like the other animals. They have to have their food fresh. Eagles You can learn a lot from an eagle. You can learn a lot from a lion. Did you know that the lion is not the strongest animal in the jungle at all? But you know why he is the way that he is? Why he's the king of the jungle? Who knows that? Why is the lion the king if he's not the strongest? Who knows? Anybody know? I'm gonna tell you right now. The elephant, when the elephant is around the lion, the elephant is huge, big, strong. He could smash that lion. But the lion, the reason why he is the king of the jungle is because of his attitude. His attitude. When he sees the elephant, he doesn't run. He sees lunch. He sees lunch. I'm gonna eat you. You're big. You're huge. But I'm